all want true love in our lives, but the reality is, love is hard to find, and even harder to keep.
I think I was just tired of the regular Kenyan men, no offense.
Perception is created by the individual based on what you're missing.
And when I see him so free with other females, I feel bad.
When a woman feels insecure, she will look for security somewhere else.
It's important to know a love language. There are ladies who don't mind, even if he doesn't call. I like my space.
Do you think that we should share passwords or not?
When you look for something, you will get it.
I'm Tamima, and this is Real Talk. We all want true love in our lives, but the reality is, love is hard to find, and even harder to keep. Well, my guests on the show today are saying, Tamima, the heart is saying yes, but the mind, I'm not sure. So should I keep that lover or lose that lover? Welcome to the show.
Constantly calling when I'm at work.
I think I was just tired of the regular Kenyan men. No offense.
Manomenda liongea, kamuliza, mbona haukuji.
When a woman feels insecure, she will look for security somewhere else.
Tuning in now. Today we'll be getting real on some common issues that normal everyday couples often go through. So my guests will be coming on sharing their stories with us, and I have experts, counselors who will be trying to help them fix their problem. And also my audience will be chiming in and calling it, should they keep that love or lose that love? Well, I'd like to introduce my first guest. I have Trina Mudezi, 22, and Samuel Luchemu. They're a couple, and they're saying that they've worked together at some point. They started dating on and off, and right now they're not really sure. Should they keep at it or should they just break it off? Please help me welcome Tina to the show. Tina.
Yes.
So for you, the heart is saying yes. Lakini, the mind is saying, I'm not sure. The mind is saying no.
Yeah.
It's not even, I'm not sure.
Okay, dilemma.
Dilemma, okay. So tell me, you and Samuel, you work together?
Yeah, both of us, we have different production. We are both producers. I'm a producer at Sequel Star Production, and he's a producer in another production.
So how did the two of you meet?
Okay, we once went for an audition, and that's where we met. Yeah.
Because you work at two different companies.
By then, we did not know about each other. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So then is when we get to know each other, and we have a common interest.
Which, of course, is both your love for production and acting.
Yeah, okay. Sure.
So let's invite Samuel over and hear his side of the story. Samuel, welcome to Real Talk.
Hello.
So I'm sure you heard everything that Tina said about the relationship.
Yeah.
So maybe let's start off with what attracted you to her, because you're the one who approached her.
Basically her beauty, her intelligence, everything about her made me whole. You can't explain it. It's something that you feel that there's an emptiness you feel inside you, and with her I felt everything.
So do you acknowledge that? That's
yeah.
How you make him feel?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So, but now she's saying that she's not sure whether you guys are meant to be, or maybe you should just stay friends. So how does that make you feel, hearing that from her?
It's really painful because I try as much as I can basing on the work I do. So I really wish we could make it better, because deep inside it hurts me. At times I get home late, extremely late, and then we haven't spoken like the whole day. So I try to find a way for us to connect, but you know, at times your work gets more.
So, but for you as Samuel, is this relationship something that you're committed to? Is your heart saying yes and your mind saying yes, or like her, you're also conflicted?
My heart is there. Though at times I feel like, you know, I'm not so sure, but yes, my heart is there with her.
What about your mind? Do you feel like this is it? Whatever she wants me to do, I'll put in the work. Ama pia akili sasa inakwambia, ah, kuna stress hapa sasa.
There are times you feel like, yes, a lot of stress, because it's no lie, yeah, a lot of stress. But at the end of the day, there's no other person who'd understand me better than her.
We are looking at issues that most couples, especially young couples, go through. So probably if I had to start with you, Robert, you're listening to what, how they feel about each other. Obviously, there's a lot of love here, but for some reason, the heart is saying yes, but from both parties, we are seeing the cracks.
Right. What I sense is a bit of selfishness on, you understand? Okay. What I sense is a bit of selfishness from the lady's side and the lack of assurance from the man's side. Yes, you do have the right to call him as your man, but you must have the wisdom to know what time to call him. If you are both producers, then you understand the nature of his work. Unless maybe the gentleman has shown something that may pour or plant the seed of doubt. But from what I'm hearing, he's given to her.
Maybe let's clarify from her. Has he given you a reason to be insecure, like Robert is asking?
Yeah, sure, he has.
How, when?
As I said earlier, he tend to take a lot of time with the cast. You know, there's, you have...
When you say cast, male or females?
Females.
So the girls around him.
Yeah. So there's that boundary as a producer you have to create between you and the cast. And we still have an immediate director or co-producer to handle the cast. But when you're the producer and then you're handling everything, even you don't have time for your wife, that creates an alarm, you see? Like, according to me, my production,
all right,
I must make sure, like, I have this time with my boyfriend. So there's no way I'll just start, like, being so free with the gents and other, like, who? The crew, so free with them until he's so jealous. So I can't do that. And also I'm jealous. And when I see him so free with other females in the film, I feel bad.
Do you think you're free with females? With the ladies, like you flirt a lot? That's what she's basically saying.
Okay, yes, I admit, yes, sometimes I do that. I don't know why I do it, but at times I do it.
And let me just rope in Pauline Wawera, because Pauline, you're a counselor.
Yeah.
And probably here there's an angle, because I can see that she's 22, he's 30. Mm. So just like Robert said, because he's at a stage whereby career is important. Mm. And she's 22, she's just starting out. Ideally, could the age difference also be a factor here in that there are two different places in their lives? Mm.
Well, definitely age is always a factor, because Samuel is getting into probably midlife and he wants to catch up. You know, what didn't I do when I was in the 20s? So I need to do it. So he definitely has to be busy. But then I wanted to say, on that I would like to say, it's important for them to discuss whether him working away many times, because I gathered he works away many times.
Which is production,
mm-hmm. But is it working for you as a couple? Because if it's going to go on, what are you ready to lose? Would you rather lose a job or a marriage? I'm just putting you to the deep sea. I mean, it's hard to, you know, we need food, we need all this, but it's very important for a couple to be very objective. I know, is this working for us? I like the way you say, there's a time you asked her to come over, but then she couldn't leave her job. So is there something like that? Just being candid, because at times what keeps us away are the wants but not the needs. And I gather you're quite new in your marriage, so probably you need a lot of time together. I like that she's vulnerable enough to say that she's jealous. And I wanted to say that most of the times the things that attract us to our spouses are the things that bring issues later. It's important to know a love language. There are ladies who don't mind, even if he doesn't call. I like my space. I've had ladies tell me that I don't want him. He keeps calling me. It's like he wants to know where I am all the time. So learning, she has said her love language is you coming in all the time, calling her up, and if that's her love language, probably for Samuel, he doesn't really mind. He knows that he loves you, and if anything changes, he will tell you. You know what they say?
Right.
I love you, but if anything changes, I'll let you know. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
So I would like to ask, yeah, and this is probably the audience, because remember we say that these are common relationship issues that most couples actually go through. So audience, what do you guys think? Should they keep that love or lose that love?
I think they should maintain their love, because the point of Tina thinking that his lover has more concentration of to ladies more than he has to her should not make them to be apart, because I think her point outweighs the other good things that a lover does to her. So I think they should maintain their love.
Okay, thank you very much. I think in your introduction, when you introduce yourself to us, it would have been extremely important for you to tell us how long you've stayed, because both of you have said something that is extremely absurd, because you say, my heart is willing, both of you, your heart is willing, but then your mind is unwilling. So I would tend to think, how many days or how many years or how many months have you been courting or have you been dating for you people? Because it takes, actually for a long life, you know, relationship, if you've stayed like 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 months, then at least you know for sure this is my partner. But I'm a bit confused when you say my heart is willing, but my mind is unsettled, and I don't know, you should have told us we've been staying together, we've been pushing or courting for about 3 or 4, 5 months, then we could have a better, clearer picture of what's going on. Thank you.
They mentioned that they have been on and off for a year, so it's whereby, and the time and the time you spend together, yes, is probably what she's complaining about, but it's a year, right?
Yes, yeah. A year.
So how are the both of you feeling? Do you feel like now, you know what, we've had the expert advice and we think that we can work this out? Let's start with you, Tina.
Okay, according to me, you know, love conquers everything. Okay, according to me, I'm really ready to change the nagging part and the too much calling. Yeah, I'm willing to change and to give him space to work as much as he's giving me my space to work. Then when we come together and we have that one project we want to do together, we can still do it as a couple.
Okay, would you be open to that, Samuel, working with her and still staying in a relationship?
Yes. Honestly, yes, I am willing to work with her and be in a relationship with her. Yes, at times it might be a bit confusing, but I'm open to it. Yes.
Right, there you had it. So Tina and Samuel, they're promising to work on their love. And when we come back, I have more couples who will be sharing some of the issues that they are going through. Remember, you can join the conversation via the hashtag #RealTalkWithTamima. Right now, it's time for a quick break. I'll be right back.
Nikachukua simu, nikashika, nikaweka loudspeaker, nikamwambia ongea. Mwanaume ndo aliongea, akamuliza mbona haukuji?
And if you've been together for 4 years, marafiki zako lazima wajue you're married.
I think I was just tired of the regular Kenyan men. No offense.
Perception is created by the individual based on what you're missing.
Welcome back. back to Real Talk. Now, our conversation on today's topic continues. My guests are asking Tamima, should I lose that lover? The next couple that I have on is Duncan Umbima, 32, and Ivy Simiu, who is 25. They have been together for 4 years, and they say their main issue is communication. So he's saying that, I feel that she's not easy to communicate with. And she's saying that, I feel like he's absent from the relationship. So please help me welcome Ivy to the show. Ivy, welcome to Real Talk.
Thank you.
So probably tell me about you and Duncan, because 4 years is a long time. How did you guys meet?
Okay, me and Dan, we met in 2014. He was doing video shooting in Kajiado. And then I was a dancer. And then in the process, we exchanged contacts. And then after a year, we now started dating seriously.
And so if you look back, what's that one thing about Duncan that you're like, okay, this could be the guy?
About Duncan, well, I find him fun. He's nice. He understands me. Yeah.
And right now, 4 years down the line, so what's this issue between the two of you that's now making you think that, hey, maybe I'm wasting my time here and I need to leave this relationship?
To begin with, Duncan is a public figure. He's a gospel singer. So sometimes I find it challenging because he has so many female friends, and most times he spends on his phone. So I get uncomfortable.
Have you communicated it to him?
Yeah, I have. We have talked about it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but I'm not so comfortable.
So what makes you uncomfortable? Because I can imagine, like you said, he's a public figure. So of course he'll interact with people from both genders. So what's the thing about his interaction, specifically with the females, that makes you uncomfortable?
Well, he posts photos online.
But maybe those are just his fans. You say
yeah,
he's a public figure.
It's his fans, but it makes me uncomfortable.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And what else?
So, also the phone calls. And so much time on his phone.
So you feel like when he's on his phone, he's chatting, WhatsApping with other women?
Yeah, most of his friends are women. So
okay, so maybe it's time to meet Duncan and just hear his side of the story. Please help me welcome Duncan. Hello.
Yes.
So you've heard what Ivy feels. So probably listening to her, and she's saying that she's very specific about what is making her unhappy. Do you acknowledge that?
Mina jaribu yangu my best. I try sana kumwelewa. Because yeye ni mwanamke, lazima kwe jealousy. But hiyo hizi kwa main issue kwa sababu anajua kazi yangu na hiyo kazi imefanya haizi lala njaa. Unacheki vya hako ana shine juu ya kazi yangu. So sijui ana complain nini, unaona? Mimi nimekubali kuhusu time yangu. Sometimes naenda shooting nje. Okay, I'm a casting manager. Sometimes niko nimetoa kazi nje. Labda nimeingia kwa set saa 12 asubuhi na shoot paka labda pia saa 12 ile nyingine asubuhi. Unajua 24 hours nimemaliza kule nje. Lakini saa yeye hawezi understand. But mimi nimechelewa atanigombanisha nini lakini pia sijaingia kwa nyumba mikono mitupu, unaelewa? mwanaume lazima ongee na kile kibage kitu kama hiyo lakini sijejue utaka nini namwambia mam hii ndo kazi yangu na hii ndo inafanya tuko pamoja ndio inafanya unang'aa unavaa unakula ndio inafanya yani unakuwa mke wangu unaelewa
mam hakubaliani na hiyo statement anakaa amekasirika so Ivy what about nini kenye Dana anasema pale unasema hapana na kuona tuna sana Tamima hapana
He left out the part of social media, the social media thing.
So you go through his profiles?
Sometimes.
Are you aware she goes through your profiles?
Unajua, naweza kwa, sometimes, mi ukasirika naye sana. Okay, unaelewa, umeka simu hapo, umelala macho moja kama nini unaelewa. Lakini unapata, ako kwa simu. Sasa nashinda unaangalia nini kwa simu, unaona? Na simu mimi peke yangu mwenye makosa. Nakumbuka kuna siku tulikosana, simu ni muhimu sana na simu ndio inakosanisha sometimes wale couples, unaelewa? Juzi tulikuwa tumelala. Nikasikia simu yake inalia saa 8 usiku. Nikamwambia shika simu. Alikataa kushika. Nikamwambia shika simu. Saa 8 usiku. Nikachukua simu nikashika, nikaweka loudspeaker nikamwambia ongea. Mwanaume ndo aliongea akamuliza mbona haukuji. Hiyo kitu sikuelewa paka saizi. Unaelewa ilinuma sana. Tukaongea tukagombana paka asubuhi, unaelewa? Akaniambia na marafiki zangu wa kitambo hawajajua nimeolewa vitu kama hizo. Hizo miaka zote tumekuwa na wewe.
Miaka 4.
Hizo zote tumekuwa na wewe. Huyo mtu anataka nini saizi? Unaenda wapi? Hujakuja wapi? Hebu nielezee, unaelewa? So hizo ndio vitu zinafanya ni una feel ni kama siko niko unaelewa? Yeah.
So Ivy unasemaje? Because unaona anasema venye unamwambia anapata messages, wewe unaingia kwenye profile yake, you're finding DMs from women, lakini pia anasema acha yangu message, wale wanatuma siwaambi watumi, lakini wewe unapigiwa simu usiku wa usiku.
Yeah, I was called usiku, but the caller was someone I knew from way back, so I didn't even expect the call because even the number sikwan may save kwa phone yangu. Yeah.
So you're saying that he has no reason to be insecure?
Yeah, and I tried explaining to him and then he was all angry.
So
upset.
Are you working?
Yeah.
What do you do?
I have a salon and a cosmetics shop.
So part of why you're also unhappy, you're saying he's always away, but you're not too happy with what he's bringing home.
With what he's bringing home, I can't say I'm not too happy with what he's bringing home. Actually, I'm not happy with the kind of, you know, the flirting and all that.
So you're happy with him taking care of you, but it's just the work that enables him to do it is what you're not happy with and how he has to do the work.
Yeah, how he has to do the work.
Okay, are there any other issues? Because it says here that you're also not quite happy with her temper. You feel like she can be very moody.
Okay, hiyo naelewa, but sometimes mu control, anajua. Nikikasirika, sometimes natoka kwa nyumba na machana fasi, naenda mbali. Lakini Tamima bado hujanisaidia. Nataka umulize mbona hakushika ile call. Mbona alikataa kushika. Hiyo ndio reason.
That's why I have experts on this show. I told you I have Robert Burale, the coach. I have Pauline. I have Lina. I have Dedan. So let me start with Burale.
Well, it's a very complex situation, but the gentleman is very hurt about that phone call.
Very hurt.
Because men are ego. The one thing about a man is that he cannot share his woman. He can share anything else, but not his woman. And the lady has said that she didn't even know that number. Meaning then, if somebody called you at midnight, it could be an emergency, so you should have answered. And the fact that somebody asked Mbona Haukuji tells me there was prior communication to agree that you are being expected somewhere. So, vile hukuchukua simu, ilimuonesha ni kama kuna mtu mwingine pia kando. And maybe it is because also, she's feeling insecure because of what she's getting on your DMs. And yes, on DMs, I cannot even control the messages I get. Some of the messages I get are very vulgar. But maybe it is your response. If you respond positively to some very funny flirting, then anakuwa insecure. You understand? So I think what needs to happen, and if you've been together for 4 years, marafiki zako lazima wajue you're married. In fact, not even 4 years. If you're together for 4 months, they should know you're married. And that makes the man feel secure. So what I think they need to do is have trust and communication. If you don't have a relationship on the foundation of trust and communication, you are like a dark woman or a dark man in a dark room winking at a woman and expecting a reaction. Nothing will happen. You'll be going nowhere. You'll take one step forward and two steps back. So I think what needs to happen is kama ulichukua, you answered the phone and put on speaker. Did she answer when aliulizwa mbona haukuji? Alinyamaza.
Hivi unakubali ulinyamaza kimya? Mbona ulinyamaza? When you mesema, you didn't know who that was?
Okay, the tone, ile tone alikuwa ananiuliza nayo, it was frightening, and so I had to keep quiet first, you know. I wasn't happy.
You should never be frightened in the presence of your husband.
Like, he was angry and
because
not frightened.
Then what you should have said, if there was nothing like that, to assure your husband, ungemuliza wewe ni nani? Where are you expecting me? Ingempatia assurance. But my brother, you also now need to assure her. Because as long as anapata ma DM, she's a beautiful lady, you're a handsome man. And social media is an animal. There are people who can sleep with you for the price of a donut. So when she starts reading those messages, she'll be like, your attention is divided. When a woman feels insecure, she will look for security somewhere else. That is why she'll receive a phone call at 2 a.m. and aulizwa mbona haukuji. You understand? Give her the attention. But what you need, I can sense, Tamima, there are underlying issues that have not been resolved. So what they're doing, they're sweeping things under the carpet. Because anasema, they spoke from midnight to morning. And yet the gentleman has asked you, Tamima ujansaidia, mbona haku jibu hiyo simu. It means you're sweeping many things under the carpet. What you need to do, have an honest conversation. Because you're sweeping things under the carpet, after some time, the house will start smelling. And you'll be forced to lift the carpet. When you lift the carpet, there'll be rats coming out. Na mtatoroka nyumba. You're still young. You are still young. You got to have communication. You got to have trust. Because if you don't, not even 5 years will you be together.
So let me hear from Lina, a woman's perspective.
When I was growing up, my mom used to tell me a man's phone ni kitungu, usishike simu ya mwanaume, ni kitungu. Because the minute you even touch the lock screen, the minute you have something at the back of your mind telling yourself that, kuna lina mwingine ana text boy wangu, what will happen? The devil always goes before us. Utapata yo text ya sasa babe. And then you'll be all ranting. What a man needs is peace and honesty. I am a firm advocate of the young girl building this man out here. Because this man, and to my fellow brothers, I stand to be corrected. And I feel like these men have been raised up in a society that expects so much. And picking up from how you are addressing your issue, I sense like there are some faces in your life you've not closed. There are some chapters and there are some people in the chapters that you really need to block and dust for your relationship to stand. Because you cannot say that you have a right to be called by whoever, because your man is not at peace. To my brother, you're a musician, you're a socialite, yeah? Remember their boundaries. For her to be shining, a relationship has more than shine, glamour, name it. There is more, you know? Are you setting boundaries with all these females out here? We understand. We want you to grow. We want your brand to grow because she is behind your success. But remember, she cannot be behind your success if you're riding for other women at the back door when she's seated there at the co-drivers. You really have to slam these doors for these women for her to be at peace. And again, insecurity in a relationship is normal, but again, it can mess with your mental state greatly. Reading his DMs will only pile up your insecurity and you may lose it. And who knows, you might go an extra mile to doing something that you may regret years later.
Lina, I have a question for the audience. And because here, there's also an angle, passwords. Yeah, for those who are in relationships, I want to sample the audience. Do you believe that if you're a couple or if you're married, your significant other should have access to your phone? Clap if you believe. Yes. Your password lazima. Who doesn't agree? Clap if you don't agree. So I'm seeing, first of all, Tina and Samuel are like, we don't agree. So Tina and Samuel, you don't have each other's passwords. Okay. And apo sando pia issues in anza. Insecurity. Okay. You're fine with that. You never want each other's passwords. Okay. So let me hear. I want to hear from someone in the audience who believes that I really must have that password. It is my right. Hey, the women's hands went up so quickly.
I believe in having the password. I'll give a personal example, personal story. I got sick and he needed to get my folks' number. He has a password. Ata ya M-Pesa, ya ATM, mumwachia. I also have his. I foresee a situation whereby you need to salvage a situation in terms of a medical emergency, or you're trying to help someone somewhere, and this, your significant other, is the one that has that number. So for me, I'm comfortable with him having my password. I do not have a problem, just like I have his.
So Robert, please help me address this, because I'm hearing the guys who are saying they need the passwords, yes, they're making a valid point, but I'm kind of feeling that also they're not being honest about why that password must be had. It is not about emergency here.
Yeah, the truth of the matter, it sounds politically correct when you say it's for emergency.
Yes. Because I would think if we're in a relationship and it's that deep, I can take your mother's contacts and put them on my phone. I don't need passwords.
You should always have your mother-in-law and your father-in-law's number in your phone.
Yeah.
But having said that, as much as some may be genuine, the majority would want the passwords to police their spouse.
There you go.
And what you go to understand, when you look for something, you will get it. For example, you're dating somebody who is a corporate, works in the corporate entity, and they had a very important meeting that afternoon. And somebody replies, sends a message and says, that was very deep. Now, when you read it with something else in your mind,
But
maybe the person meant that was a deep meeting.
Absolutely.
But because you are looking for something, because you've already judged either your husband or your wife, it will not be a deep meeting. She will understand, or he will understand, maybe there was a sexual relationship. Mm. You understand? Or you say, oh my goodness, that was too long. Maybe you're saying your boss spoke for too long. But in your mind, because you're looking for something, you'd think the session was too long. So what you got to understand is, it is okay to have the passwords, but for genuine reasons. If I leave my phone there and you have my password and there is no medical emergency, will you just leave the phone? The chances are, no, you will not. Especially, and I'm sorry to say this, we are raising this young generation is a lost generation. We are no longer dating for love, for purpose. We are dating for security purposes. You're like the FBI.
What do you think? Do you think that we should share passwords or not? Get on that hashtag, #RealTalk with Tamima. We'll be right back after this break.
When fundamentals are not there, for example, I tell ladies, if a man is physically harming you, I don't care what your pastor tells you, leave.
I think I was just tired of the regular Kenyan men. No offense.
Perception is created by the individual based on what you're missing.
back to Real Talk. Thank you so much for staying with us now. Remember, our conversation on today's topic continues. Get on that hashtag, #RealTalkWithTamima. Let me know what your views, comments, and feedback are on today's topic. Now, I'd like to introduce my next guest, Kathy Ombasa. She's a divorcee, and she says she left her ex-husband because he was a deadbeat. And now she's found love online, and she's not quite sure how to connect her old love with her new flame. Please help me welcome her to the show.
Thank you.
So, Kathy, yes. First off, probably, maybe just let's start off from the point of you've mentioned that you're a mother and previously married, now divorced. Mm-hmm. So, for a minute there, you were off relationships, but you went online and you met a guy.
Yes, I did.
So, did you ever think that you would be one of the people who would find love online?
Actually, I never thought I would. Of course, I've heard before that there are dating sites. And I think I was just tired of the regular Kenyan men, no offense. So I decided to try and meet someone out there and just experience.
So what made you get tired of Kenyan men? Because I could tell they took offense. They took offense when you said you're tired of Kenyan men.
I just feel, and yeah, this is not personal, but I just feel most of them are not, they're not deep. They don't go deep into conversation and touch someone's soul. It's very... not deep. So for me,
do you think that this is probably based off your experience with your ex?
Most probably, yes.
Okay, so what did you find online when you went looking for love?
I found lots of strange stuff. Of course, dating online is not for everyone. You need to be patient, you need to have good communication skills, you need to be committed. So I joined the dating site in 2015, and I met the man of my dreams in 2017, December. So it took time.
So when you say you met the man of your dreams, you met him online because you have never seen each other physically.
I've never seen him.
And?
Face to face.
Face to face.
Yes.
So you obviously I'm sure that you use the internet, yes. Technology. Mm-hmm. So you must Skype.
Yes.
But you have never really met face to face.
Yeah, we've never met face to face. However, as you said, we do lots of FaceTime. We speak every day. Like I've spoken to him from 2017, December 25th to today, every day.
So that's almost 1.5 years.
There you go.
And I hear that your new Mr. Right, he is Caribbean American.
Yes.
So what do you love about him?
First of all, I think this man was, God thought about Kathy and created this man for me. He loves me as I am with my imperfections, because I can be a handful. He loves my kids. I feel secure with him. We talk about really deep stuff. And I trust him. And that's how we have been together till today, because we have trust. And of course, many times people will be like, He's all the way in the States. There's nothing. He must have a girlfriend. But we don't feed into that.
And so how many kids do you have?
I have two, a boy and a girl.
Does he have any kids?
No, he doesn't.
None at all?
None at all.
So what is your love question today?
My love... Okay, I actually don't have a love question. Mm-hmm. What I have is a comment, and it's based on lose that lover. Because maybe the people here who... are in that space where they are with someone and they feel they want to leave, but they don't have what it takes.
Okay, so let me ask you, your baby daddy, who you're saying you left because you felt he was a deadbeat, is he still in your life?
Not really. We talk maybe once a year.
Are you co-parenting together?
I wouldn't call that co-parenting. I'm doing everything by myself.
So what's your long-term plan with your Caribbean American Mr. Right? Is he coming over here? Are you going over there? Or are you happy the way things are?
Definitely the plan is to end up together. So right now he's just preparing for me and the kids to get there in terms of getting a bigger house, because he was alone. But the plan is he's going to come and meet my family and me. And then I'll also go and meet his family.
Let's start with Robert, because I can tell that you're really... You're really listening very deeply.
Well, I would not want to discuss the baby daddy, because I don't like discussing people who are not here to defend themselves. So let's allow that. I will not comment on that. But you said short term is to come and meet you and your people. Short term, 1.5 years is not short term. That's mid to long term. Mm-hmm. I feel, and yes, people have met love online, but I feel he should put more effort to come. Because to be honest, from America to Kenya, he would economy ticket $1,000, he'd be here. True. Now, if you've talked every day from the 25th of December 2017 to today, he must be sure enough that you're the one for him. And even if he's in employment, the employment laws state that he has 1 month off. Why has he not made time to come and meet your people? Because it's also risky to just up this place and take your kids to somebody. Yes, you have connected online and you've spoken online, but you don't know if he's good for your children. He may say he loves your children, but when the rubber meets the road is how he interacts with your children. You understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Because what may be good for you, as you say, Carol?
Kathy.
Mm-hmm. He may be tall, dark, and handsome, six-pack, but your daughter and your son don't care about a six-pack. They want somebody who will protect them, who will provide for them, and who will show them the way as far as they are growing up. You understand? Mm-hmm. So for me, I feel before you call him the man of your dreams, he better be the father of your children. You understand what I'm saying?
Let me drop in Dedan, because we have Dedan Ondiege, you're a psychologist, and I want to bring you in from the angle of online dating. So we are living in a very modern world, yeah? And you can imagine that she obviously was hurt in your previous mm-hmm. relationship. It must have been very difficult.
Yes, it was.
And this is somebody that you had kids with.
Yeah.
But do you feel that maybe she has a bit of a blind side right now that she's dating online? And of course, just basing from the questions and the holes that Burali has poked.
Kathy, meeting someone and falling in love is a good thing. You actually look at that you're in love. Mm-hmm. However, online dating have its challenges. I pick that you are running away from something. There's a statement you said that African men are there.
Kenyan men are shallow.
They are shallow. And back to your question about online dating, it is important to be careful about online dating to the extent that sometimes people may present a picture they want us to see. And as it were, with many things, perception is created by the individual based on what you're missing. So if you're missing love, anything presented to you will come in form of love. Sort out yourself in terms of yourself. I want to probably get us back to the idea of self-awareness. Be aware of what you're running away from so that you're not mad from seeing the reality.
Absolutely. Now, back to self-awareness, because I can tell you're a pretty much confident lady, and I can tell that you're very aware of the dangers that they're raising.
Completely.
So do you still feel like you trust your Caribbean American? Like, he's the real deal.
I trust him with my life. Reason I say this, I have a twin sister. She has met him on my behalf because she goes to New York several times. She's met him, met his parents. Our parents have met. I have met his parents online. My kids talk to him every day. For me, I know this is God's plan for me because I've been through it all. So just to answer your question, Burale, he has a relationship with my kids already, and he's ready to be their father, and he knows what he's taking as responsibility.
And let me go back to Paulina, because as a relationship counselor, there's so many layers to consider, because it's not just about love, like Robert mentioned. There are the kids also to consider, and then also now there's the issue of the kids have a bio dad. So she's bringing up that already as co-parents, mm-hmm. he's able to buy into your vision for both your children.
Yes.
But we usually know that sometimes not everyone is as lucky, because there are men who would go berserk. So then what advice do you give to women, perhaps to get to a place whereby your past and your future can actually coexist?
Mm.
I think first to say, before I forget this point, a mzungu, an African, a man is a man. They might be shallow, but a man is a man. They might be deep, but a man is a man. I think for me is Kathy. For me is, I heard you say that he loves you. You're a handful. I heard you say that. So for me, I would be like, what are you doing about yourself? Because could it be the handful, you being the handful, which made this first marriage? Because if you go in without working on yourself to the other marriage, then it's bound to go the same way. So for me, the challenge is coming from one relationship to the other, working on yourself. As much as, of course, you're focusing so much on him and loving him, you know, right now you're seeing each other on the screen, but you'll be living together with each other. Could it be? So for me, Tamima, I would like her to work on her being a handful. For me, that was very weighty. I'm a handful. What does that mean? Have I worked on, have I made myself better? Am I better or am I the same? Because really, if I get into another relationship, there's no magic.
Do you feel like you've worked on yourself?
Maybe I should clarify the word handful. I meant extra. You know those people who just have an extra personality? Like in the morning, me, I wake up and I'm like, morning, be it Monday or Sunday or Tuesday. And him is pretty laid back. So that's what I mean when I said I'm handful. I'm extra. Like he accepts me with my energy, with my bubbliness. That's what I meant. However, I have really worked on myself. When he met me, I was a mess. I had trust issues. I had insecurities. But sometimes when I would react a certain way, he would always remind me, I know where you're coming from, but I'm with you moving forward. So this is how we are going to do things. So I feel I have worked on myself, but of course you can never be perfect. There's much more to do, but I'm at a very good place.
Okay, I think that's very positive of you. So let's get a couple of questions from the audience. Probably someone who's not spoken.
Okay, Kathy stated when she was saying that the man that she had previously was financially unstable. So my question is, I don't know if Kathy left the man because he was unstable financially or because he had other problems with Kathy. That is the question.
Kathy?
Okay, the reason, and I'll keep it very brief, the reason we were not able to be together much longer was because all the important, the fundamental things that bring a couple together, that help the couple stay together and strive for better were not there. There was no trust, no love, no respect, no faith in someone. Like, there was literally nothing. So it had to end.
Okay, thanks a lot. I would like to ask you, Catherine, whether you have ever tried to visit the marriage counselor before the breakout, maybe to try to send you maybe your weakness you are, and because now you are not going to marry the angel, maybe you have some of those weaknesses, and maybe you need to sort them first before you settle to that man.
So your question is whether we plan to do
whether
counseling.
You worked on your last relationship before leaving it.
I did myself. Like, people used to see me walking and they're like, wow, she's still at it. I went over and above.
And maybe on that, just to clarify, Burale, at what point, because she raises some very valid points, at what point, as an individual, that even you as a life coach, you'd advise, leave, run?
I mean, first, she's such a likable lady, and I believe all of us are just wishing her the best. As she was speaking, I was like, may just this man be the bone of your bones and the flesh of your flesh, you know?
Thank you.
I just wish you the best. When fundamentals are not there, for example, I tell ladies, if a man is physically harming you, I don't care what your pastor tells you, leave. You can sort out your issues while separated, because if you don't, you'll be killed. And the same pastor who told you to stay as they pray for you will conduct your funeral. You understand? So if there is no, she mentioned trust, faith in one another, because if you cannot work as a team, and yet that is the primary reason people came together. In fact, I will say this, sex is not the most important thing. It is a benefit of people coming together in purpose. Now, if you don't trust each other, you will not work together towards purpose. So if the fundamentals are broken, yes, I know in a generation where people say God hates divorce. Well, it doesn't hate the divorcee. I'm a divorced man. It doesn't mean that marriage is not a qualification to heaven. Divorce is not a highway to hell. So if you are at risk physically, emotionally, and otherwise, I would not condemn somebody for leaving. She's saying she tried. And I'm glad the gentleman asked the question, because I was a bit worried if she said she would have left the man primarily because of his financial elasticity. Because today somebody can be broke, tomorrow his fortunes will change. Yeah. So I'm glad you clarified that, because that had disturbed me. Because then, as our brother said here, then it would have meant you are also now going to America for financial abundance. Women, if there's physical abuse, emotional abuse, put your feet on your shoulders and run. But don't run before trying. And I'm not advocating for divorce. I want to say this clearly. But you can separate as you sort out your issues and come back together. But where there's physical harm, divorce today, divorce tomorrow, divorce next week. Whoever abuses you on social media will not be there when they kill you.
Absolutely. And I really hope that you have had the tons of advice that has been given in this show today. And if you're struggling with your relationship, please feel free to reach out to any of our experts, and of course to me via Instagram, Facebook, and of course on Twitter. Thank you so much for tuning in. As always, this has been Real Talk. Until next time, enjoy the rest of your viewing.
Special thanks to E+ for medic and ambulance services.